back to this discussion. I guess we are not actually inherently violent, this human race that has evolved out of the ape. We're more like, we use this money in front to keep the violence from happening. You know, the money in front, you know, the money to buy the tree. Otherwise, I have to fight you to kill it so I can have the tree. You know what I'm saying? So we use the money in front to avoid violence. So we're more like this type of monkey. However, we have so many diets going on in this world and so many soils. And oddly, we can look at, you know, we have this phenomenon that happened with England where they had a rise of criminals and they whisked them off to Australia. Okay, so we have that moment in time. I'm like, oh my gosh, there must have been like major things going on, their soil, the diet, to create so many criminal minds. So when they had that going on, you have to look at how it was nurtured, how it was actually brought to path. Because you can't just say it's genetic, that they wanted to be evolving into monkeys, they want to steal from one tree to the next, but that's what happened. They evolved into those types of monkeys, those monkey-human. And so because this is going on, what were they eating? What were they eating in that moment, in that instance of time? You know, that whole group of people, it's very unusual. So you look at the diet, you look at the poisons, like toxins from the pewter cups, etc. Look at all of that, how that brought into the criminal mind. And so thusly, you know, so that was their answer to go put them into Australia. But in when you look at it, you look at almost a different type of monkey evolution going on. So we have the evolution of the criminal or the non-criminal in a very, very like major play. So look, I'm looking at the soil, the diet, of what was going on at that era, because it really created a real differentiation, okay? And so now, because you can't say that now all the Australians are criminals, but at that particular time, that was their answer, and that was just the way they were, that was just non-stop. And so okay, so that's a moment of a people that are changing their behavior. You know what I'm saying? So when you have major evolution changes in a group of people, a human, then of the humans, that's almost like we are. You know, you say the monkey moved off to the one way and the ape went the other. This is a moment when the human is evolving from different humans. So evolution, I believe, is never stopping. We are still evolving and still evolving. So because we are still evolving and still evolving, we need to jot it down. We have to actually figure out what are we going to be evolving into? You know, what is our direction? Who do we want to be? You know, if you look at some beautiful ducks, or you look at a beautiful monkey with a face, and they have like, there's the one, it's all black monkeys, gorgeous, with just the white eyebrows. I mean, it's almost like they have already predefined themselves and said, that's it, we're evolving into the beautiful monkey with the white eyebrows, and that's who we are, nobody else. So they made that decision almost. It's like it's up to us. Do you understand? The onus of our evolutionary direction is up to us. It's not just a random haphazard. You know, we can make the decision. We can make the decision how we want to look. We can make the decision how we are going to think. Do we all want criminal minds, in essence? You know, do we all want to have a combative behavior? You know, we can adjust the human being again and again and again into these different evolutions. So as a group of people, you know, you look at 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, you know, who will we be? You know, if we have no direction, if we have no direction at all, you know, it's just random, then it's just going to be chaos. It's just going to be more and more terrible chaos. I believe we can make a major decision. You know, parents can teach their children, and thusly those parents, when they become parents, they teach their children. And yeah, we can go on and on and on about the humor that we are just vegetables that want to procreate and have our seeds. We are just vegetables that grow. I have some lettuce that's been out there in the garden now for 4 months, 5 months. And it is just hanging out, waiting to grow into more lettuce. I have some carrots also. So they spring out. And that's all we are. We're just talking. We're talking in human form. You know, so we think we're really big and snotty against everything else. But all we are is, I want to have another child. I want to have another child. That is just your talking carrot. Do you understand? It's just your talking head of lettuce. That is not anything unusual. You are not anything different than the peach tree that says, hey, I got a seed. You are no different. You are a procreator and you can't help it. So, but you're not a procreator that's like amazing because you're human. Back to the lettuce has the same mind doing the same function. You're just the talking function. You're just the one who says and tells her girlfriend, oh my gosh, I would just love to have a boy. You're that talking function. And just because I can't hear the lettuce talk, you know, that's the separation we have here between the vegetables and the humans. Just because I can't hear that lettuce talk, that makes them all act superior, as a superior race. But we're all identifying as populators the same way. We're all infertilizers the same way. You understand what I'm saying? We just are procreators. Okay. So, as we are going forward, we identify with this, that we know that we are procreators for any way, shape, or form, because the lettuce says so. Your lettuce inside, your carrot and your spinach leaves, they say so. You procreate. Well, apparently we have brains to understand this. So if we have brains to understand this and we can communicate this, we can say, hey, maybe we don't want to be that type of a fruit or that type of a vegetable. This is the whole human race. Let's not be that type of a fruit. Let's be a different type of fruit. Let's be a fruit that says, hey, maybe I only want to procreate once in 5 years. You know how the wolves do? They have the once a year. They decide, the female wolf goes into the men's once a year. Not these stupid women. Not the men's, I meant the other thing, goes into heat, they call it. It only allows the egg, the fertility, once a year. So all of this going on, we can modify ourselves. I believe we can modify ourselves, but how can we just do it through thinking power? Does it have to be this abstinence? Does it have to be this ridiculous, all of this bringing in all of this condoms and all of these other things? Is there a way that we can evolve to procreate only once every 5 years? Because then we bring this human race into something a little bit more, you know, deal with it. You know, maybe we just don't want to be the every month type of a vegetable. maybe we don't want to be that anymore. Let's try another way. So how can we evolve? Head brains here. That's where I'm at. Trying to figure out how we can evolve out of being a vegetable that wants to season and season and season. Do you understand? Yeah. And then we have the woman who wanted 8 of them or something. And so those types of freaks, those are just like when you have the carrot and it has 2, or the carrot and it has like a doubler or a tripler on your beet or something odd. It's just something odd, you know. And somehow the societies accept that woman, and she's a freak. She's like a freak vegetable. I don't understand the acceptance. That's a no. You know, we have to have our discipline like we have with our dogs. That's a no. You know, it's like, you know, you don't let your dog go out in the street. You say no. You tell it no. Behavior, discipline moment. And you make sure it doesn't do it again. And you get it back there, you leash it, you're stern. Because he can learn or she can learn just from that stern moment. You don't kick it, you're nice. But you're stern with the tone of your voice. And so that dog learns. So we have to be stern to these people. We don't just keep giving them silver platters of here's fertility, fertility, fertility. We don't do that. It's the opposite. We are in the opposite tantrum of this evolution of humans. We have to do the exact opposite. We have to go to the wolf direction. We have to go to once in 5 years a woman goes into heat. We are just the worst, worst, most oversexed, disgusting apes that I know. I've seen some apes that are really, really overdone. I have seen some, but I believe that was a behavior instance of their location and they were overcrowded. So I don't think that is normal. I don't think that's normal for those apes. I don't think they were that supposed to be that oversexed. But this group of humans is disgustingly oversexed. This human ape, that's something we can evolve away from. We have a choice. Do you understand? So whether that is we learn in our behavior, we have to be taught that from little children, and until it goes into the next generation. I mean, evolution takes a long time. Maybe 1,000 years from now, we finally stop being oversexed. But we can do it. Do you understand? I believe we can do that. Anyway, so yeah, so how do we form ourselves as? What are we evolving into? Because right now, it does look like we have all these sectors. We have the evolution of the Arabs, and we have the evolution of what's going on in the Canadians. We have the evolution of Africa with many of the different African countries, okay? All the African people. All of those, they're eating different soils, eating different foods, very, very, very different. We can look at this entire mesh as they're evolving away from each other. You know what I mean? We're all evolving. The Africans are evolving away from the Arabs, and the Arabs are continually evolving away from the Canadians. So that creates our different monkeys, you know, so our different ape. So this is how, you know, we became the Chinese look, or how we became this white face look. These are evolution monkeys. I'm an evolution monkey of the white face. Okay, that's all I am. I've evolved to this evolution monkey, so I am different. I'm a different monkey than the Arab monkey. I am a different monkey than if I was only Italian. You understand? So, anyway. So now we have all of these different monkeys, but yet we're all trying to say we're human. in reality, we are breeds, like breeds of dogs. Okay, so we can look at that. We are breeds of dogs. Okay, I've done the vegetable thing, but we're still thinking like a vegetable that wants to procreate. Okay, so we are the breeds of the dogs. Simple as that. We can call ourselves human, just like they do, but yet we're different. Okay, so we do this, and then, anyway, yeah, and then we have the people that do, then we have the other that we're all folding in. We're becoming a mixed, back into the mixed dog. And so when we go back into the mixed dog, that just changes everything that evolved out. So it's a very odd situation when you look at it this way. It's, you have the Chinese that evolved this way, the Arabians, the Africans, the Canadians, all evolved different. And then now we're trying to take everybody back and put them into the one face. And it's a very strange. Maybe there's nothing we can do about that. Maybe that's oversexed. Maybe that's an oversexed issue. I would almost say it was an oversexed issue, but I it starts touching into racism. It's like, what? You know, they put all these other things in the front of it. But in essence, it has stopped our true evolution moment. Like you take all of those people from the Nordic race, you take them, it stopped them from all being 6 feet tall. You know what I mean? That's an evolution moment. And it stopped I can't say anymore. But anyway, so we're here evolving. And now we're devolving a little bit in just our physical form and our physical look. But in reality, we still have the brain that's evolving in front of all of this exterior. We still, in behind this exterior, we still have the brain, and the brain itself is saying, procreate once every 5 years. Yes. Slow it down. Slow it down. Where are we going in this vessel, this human vessel? Where are we going, and what do we want to look like? What do we want to think like? We already are thinking like the veg, tabala. So if we are this, can we change our vegetable? That's really where I'm at.